what's up guys? We're back outside and today is the day we're testing out these homemade pull-tab pyrotechnics. The idea here really is convenience. Rather than having to light a fuse with a barbecue igniter, we want to be able to pull these tabs and have our pyrotechnics light themselves. So let's dive right in and see if they actually work. Now to kick things off, I'm going to get started with one of these small paper tubes that we made. This is the smallest and one of the cleanest ones that I've made, so it should give us the safest results. Moment of truth, guys. Let's go light it off.
Theoretically, I should just be able to pull this and the thing will light itself. Let's see if that's really the case. Haha, handle broke.
I need more friction.
Oh dude, the fuse came out. What the heck? Oh, it's still gonna work though. There it goes. Nice. I love the smell of smoke bomb in the morning. So that was a success. It wasn't nearly as dangerous of a burn as I thought it was going to be. So for this one, I think I'm going to try pulling the tab and throwing it more smoke grenade style. That was cool. Did you hear the way that popped when it went off? It was like, bang. It went off the wrong direction though. It kind of shot off to the side and I wanted it more pointed inward. So I'm gonna grab another one. We're gonna try that again. There it goes. I really want that thing to go up right now. Woo. Look at the smoke. Look over by the slide. Look up into the trees. That's a lot of smoke.
Yep, not gonna complain about that. That's awesome.
Let's check out the damage.
Our pyrotechnic compositions melted off the hot glue and they just fall off the cardboard bases. But surprisingly, the cardboard bases didn't ignite on fire. They're just charred. These pieces of paper have crumbled into ash. That's 100% success so far. Let's go bigger.
I'm not exactly sure how we're gonna do it, but for this next one, I'd like to see two go off at once.
Cool, here we go.
Sweet! Oh, the other one's not taking off. Come on, you can do it.
Oh, there it goes. Oh, that's a fair amount of smoke. Wow, look over here. Look over by the trees and the pond. That house is just completely covered in a smoke screen. That's awesome. Wow. Cool. That was awesome. For this next experiment, let's try taking one of these big ones, burying it in the sand pit, and seeing how these things do underground.
Will it even light off?
We're about to find out.
Here we go.
Moment of truth.
Whoa! Whoa!
That's kind of cool.
It's still burning underground. Look at that. It's like spewing ash. It looks like a volcano. Look at that, all the smoke rising up out of the sand with a little geyser coming up from the top. Ooh, that's really hot. As you'd expect it would be, right? Look at that, oh my gosh, that is freaking cool. Wow. This is way too much fun. Okay, that exceeded my expectations. So apparently smoke bombs will go off underground. Who knew? We're down to our last two pyrotechnics and I saved the best for last. We've got this refurbished smoke grenade and a cup full of the leftovers. Let's go with the grenade first. I think for this one I'm gonna get a little bit gutsy and see if I can hold on to the container while it actually smokes and goes off. This burns a lot hotter and a lot more vigorously than the normal smoke composition that would be in here because we're using the potassium nitrate. But that's why I'm wearing gloves. Safety first. I'm looking forward to this one. Here we go. Oh wow, that works better than I thought. Whew. It's raining hot ash on me, but it's working. Look, it's working really well. That is a lot of smoke. And it's not even hot on the outside. I can hold it barehanded and that feels just fine. This blows me away. I was expecting flames to be shooting out of there, but the flames seemed to be tempered and it was just a lot of really good smoke. I do feel the heat starting to transfer down to the plastic now, but for the most part, that was an epic success. I'm really proud of that, guys. That worked really, really well. For the grand finale, let's bring out Big Bertha.
This one here, guys, I'm really looking forward to. That is a lot of material, and I think it's gonna get really hot really fast. So we're gonna do it close to water. Now, if you look in the center here, you can see that as the composition cooled, it actually sucked down quite a bit into the center. So I'm not sure how well that fuse is gonna stay on. I'm hoping there's still enough friction in there to hold the fuse and the igniter in place as we pull it. So let's go find out. Not gonna lie, I'm a little bit nervous about this one, but we just gotta suck it up. Here we go. Oh yeah, there's plenty of delay time there. Oh, there it goes.
The flames are shooting at least 2 feet tall. And look at all that smoke.
Oh my heck, that was a lot of smoke.
I wouldn't be surprised if the neighbors complain on that one. Let's take a look at the glass. Oh my goodness, look at the top here,
where the rim used to be. I'm actually really surprised that that stayed intact as much as it did. But you can see the top just fell off. I thought for sure this glass would have been completely disintegrated. That was a pretty good sized fireball, guys. And honestly, I can't think of any better way to deal with leftovers than to light them off in style.
So guys, let's recap what just happened. We started off with our smallest and cleanest smoke bombs because we weren't sure they'd even work at all, but they did work. So we tossed them hand grenade style and watched them go off, and that was fun. And then we moved it up to lighting off two of them at the same time. That was so much fun, we moved over to the sand pit to see if our smoke bombs could still burn underneath the sand, and they did. And actually, that right there is probably the most surprising thing of this whole experiment for me today. We lit one of our smoke bombs off inside of a plastic grenade, and that was a tremendous success. And we took all the leftover scraps, put them in a cup, and lit them off by my fish pond. A day like this just can't get any better unless you have a little bit of pyrotechnics and a whole lot of smoke. Thanks for joining me for this experiment, guys. I'll be looking for you in the next one. Talk to you then. Oh, it just came right out. I need a better way to hold that.